Jay Haynes with the Film Sensei YouTube channel. In this tutorial, I will show you exactly how to rig up and animate these battle warship guns using assets from Production Crate as well as Blender and HitFilm Pro. This tutorial contains a time-stamped table of contents for your reference. Starting at productioncrate.com, I am downloading the Space Warship 1 model. A link is in the description below. Importing this model into Blender, you will see right away that it is very large. I scaled this model down to 1% of its normal size to work with. You can scale it down to whatever size you wish. Looking at this model, you can see that it is one complete mesh with four different gun turrets. Two on top and two on the bottom. Zooming in on the top front turret, you can see that there is a base that, if separated from the warship, could be rotated around, as well as a pair of guns that, if separated again, could be tilted up and down. I am going to select these parts of the mesh and separate them to be animated independently. I will start by switching to edit mode. And then I will use the Select Lasso tool to select just the turret, its guns, and its base. To make this easier, I will start by toggling on X-ray, which will allow for the selecting through items. Switching to Face Select mode, I will lasso as much of the turret as I can. To check if I have successfully grabbed all of the faces, I will use the Grab tool, shortcut G, and pull it away from the rest of the mesh. Hit Escape to undo. If need be, use the Shift key to select or deselect any faces as necessary. Next, I will separate this part of the mesh by clicking Mesh, Separate, Selection. Notice that a new mesh has been added to the collection. I will rename it Top Front Turret Rotation. Now I want to separate the guns from the base of the turret. Looking closely at the turret using wireframe mode, you can actually see that it has been designed to be separated and tilted from a point inside the turret. That will make this job very easy. Again, in X-ray mode, I will select as many faces of the guns as I can using the Select Lasso tool. Unfortunately, I have also selected faces on the turret that I do not want to select. Using the Shift key, I will deselect those faces. Again, use the Grab tool, shortcut G, to pull those faces away and confirm that you have only selected the ones that you want. Hit Escape to undo, and when you are ready, separate those parts the same way we did before. Rename this mesh Top Front Turret Tilt. Repeat these steps for the other three turrets, and then export it as its own model. Now the warship is ready to be brought into HitFilm for rigging. In HitFilm, I can import the model by clicking the arrow next to Import under the Media tab and select 3D Model. Since the model is a little dark, I will temporarily increase the diffuse color values in the 3D Model's property window to the maximum. This will make the model easier to see while rigging. Also, under the Groups tab, I will select every part of the model to be imported as a separate group. Then I can click OK. After creating a new composite shot, I will drag the model in. I will then select New Layer and add a camera to make the scene 3D. Under the Viewer tab, I will change the view to right and get a side look at the model. By selecting the different groups, I can see where all the parts are. Splitting the view into two, I will select the right view and the top view. Zooming in on the top front turret, I am noticing that the turret rotation looks to be anchored properly, but the guns are not. That's okay. We will fix that when we place the rigging points. First, let's create a new point to which I can parent the whole warship. Make it 3D, call this point Warship Control, and parent the space warship under models to it. Now create another new point, also making it 3D. Rename it to Top Front Turret Rotation and parent it to the warship control point. Since the position of the top front turret rotation group is exactly where I want the point to be, I will simply copy these position values to the position values of the point. Now I can parent the top front turret rotation group under models to that point. To create the rigging points for the guns, I will duplicate the top front turret rotation point and rename it Top Front Turret Tilt. Now I need to move it to the correct tilting position for the guns. To do this, I will temporarily change the scale of the top front turret rotation group to 0%. Going back to a single right view and zooming in, I can see exactly where I need to position this point to control the gun's tilt. After placing it in the correct position, I will parent the top front turret tilt group to that point. I will then parent the top front turret tilt point to the top front turret rotation point. Lastly, I will change the scale of the top front turret rotation group back to 100%. Now, if I manipulate these two points, you can see that the turret is fully functional with both base rotation and gun tilting. I will now go ahead and rig up the other three turrets in exactly the same fashion. I'm Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel, and that is how you rig up these guns for animation. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Next week, I will show you how to get those guns firing. Please do me a favor and like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Thanks for watching.